Hey everyone, it's Monica with Scrapping for My Boys. So I'm here to do my first project share in my participation in the Stuff It Box Purse Bag Collab with Poet Spice for the new year for 2020. This is an all-year collab. You will see videos every single month on the third Saturday of each month. And each video will go live at 7 a.m. Pacific Standard Time or 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, depending on where it is that you are. I will have all of the information for the collab in the description box below, as well as links to all of the channels who are participating in the collab. Please be sure to go ahead and watch, subscribe, like, comment on all of the participants of the collab and see what everybody has going on. This is going to be a super fun collab. So the purpose of this collab is to create 3D boxes, purses, bags with all of the various dies that we have, as well as all of the SVG files that we have out there. Some of us are die lovers, others are electronic machine users who use SVG files. So this is the opportunity for you to bust out your dies or bust out your Cricut or Cameo to go ahead and cut out all of these awesome files that we all have and just sit there. You may also create your own boxes, purses, bags on your own, or you may also choose to alter an existing bag, purse, or box. It is not just limited to paper. You're more than welcome to use other types of fabrics and materials as long as you go ahead and you create something with it. The whole purpose of the collab is if you can stuff it, then you can use it. So this is a great gift-giving idea for when you want to give things to anybody for any type of occasion. So if you want to go ahead and play along, we'd love it. So you can do a video response or an Instagram post response. And please be sure that if you are doing either one, that you go ahead and use the hashtag StuffItBoxBagCollab. I will have that information in the description box below. That way you can be sure to tag your videos or posts with that. And we can all go check out your creations. I think that's about it for all of the information on the collab itself. So let me go ahead and get my sign out of the way and I will talk about what I created. I did go ahead and use an SVG file for my first post. So let me get this out of the way. And I am going to go ahead and show you the menu of the file that I used. I used a Dreaming Tree SVG file, and my kids are arguing downstairs. It's distracting me. Let me pause this for just 1 second. Okay, I'm back. I had to go regulate my 9-year-old and my 13-year-old fighting. Okay, but you know what? Story of my life. It's okay. So the file that I chose to use is the Copper Evening Bag by Dreaming Tree. So I will have the file linked in the description box below for those of you who have electronic machines. If you're interested and you enjoy my project and you want the file and you don't already have it, you know where you can find it. The site you can get it from is 3dsvg.com. Again, it's called the Copper Evening Bag. You have the option to buy the SVG file for just this bag, and I believe it retails for $2.99. Or you can do the bundle that has three different purses, and that's $6.99. I believe my previous project video, I showed the Gold Evening Bag. That is part of this bundle. It is a separate file, but you get the concept. So if you enjoyed that bag, I'm pretty sure you're going to enjoy this bag. Out of the entire bundle, this is my favorite purse from the bundle. And I have to say that overall, it's my favorite purse bag out of any die and any SVG file that I have. This one is number one. My favorite used to be the Divinity Designs Timeless Tote, which we are all familiar with. The bag came out, I believe, 2 years ago, and everybody loves it. But this one trumps it. I gotta say, this is my absolute favorite. And the beautiful thing about an SVG file is you can resize it to make it as small or as large as you want, as far as what you're capable of cutting. So here's the menu. It comes with all of the Dreaming Tree files. It shows you a picture of your SVG file, as well as how many sheets of cardstock that you're gonna need and all of your other supplies. And then it does show you, when you get their files, all the different pieces are on a separate file. You can combine them and merge them to open up and open them all up on one mat, or you can have different mats for each one. So here are all the different pieces. This file comes with 6 SVG actual components to go ahead and assemble your bag. All of the different pieces of everything that you will go ahead and need. I love to print this menu out. I do keep this in a binder. That way when I feel like creating, I just open up my binder and I start flipping through it. And okay, and I pick, that's what I want to create. So for my first project, this is what I created. I did go ahead and use heavyweight cardstock. And I will go over the details of all of the cardstock and all the products that I used when I do the video. When I show the project on the video, I should say. So here it is. Now let me go ahead and get this out of the way. When I went ahead and I created this, I did follow the tutorial. The owner of Dreaming Tree does do video tutorials, and they are very in-depth and very descriptive, which is awesome. So you're more than welcome to follow along and have a step-by-step guide of how to create it. I have created a multiple purses. This is the first one that I created when I started out. I absolutely love how it came out. I did create this a little bit larger than it is originally intended when you first open the file. I did enlarge the file to 120%. And let me get my ruler so I can give you measurements of the purse. So I use my Silhouette Cameo. So when I'm referencing percentage, for those of you who are Silhouette users, you guys know what I'm talking about. So it is cut at 120%. The bag itself is approximately 7 7/8 of an inch wide. It is about 1, 2, 3, 4. It's 3 5/8 of an inch deep. And if we're talking about usable space, it is 5 inches tall. If you want the height from the bottom to the top of the handle, it is going to be approximately 8 inches tall. So it is a really good size bag. If you can see, there's two little holes here. This is meant for you to go ahead and loop a tassel through it. I don't have any tassels, so I left it empty like that. And if I find a tassel, I can go ahead and add one, or I can cover up those circles if I want to. And if you want to see what it looks like, that is what it is meant to appear like with the tassel itself. Now for the file, I do have it on a magnet. The file itself does come with circles to go ahead and cover your magnets. It's originally intended to use a larger magnet, but I only have these smaller ones, and I haven't yet covered it. So that's it. That's how it is. If you go ahead and open it up, as you can see, you have all kinds of room inside here to add a whole bunch of goodies. So you essentially have all of the space of the bag itself to stuff it with whatever you want, whether it's crafting supplies, sweet treats, or other small little knickknack gifts. You have plenty of room. This purse is super sturdy. There are several layers. These files are designed extremely well, and I don't think anybody should have any trouble putting this together. It does seem like an advanced crafter type of craft, but even a beginner can do this because they do have such a good in-depth tutorial. So this is the first one that I created. This is definitely a display piece that you can just have as a display. The recipient who receives this can take their goodies out. They can re-gift it, or they can display it in their room. I will be displaying these purses in my craft room because I absolutely love them. The cardstock that I used, this is 100. The lavender is 100-pound cardstock from Poptone. You guys, you have the Prima Lavender stack, which is several years old, and White Recollections, 110-pound. I do recommend that you use at least 80-pound cardstock for this type of project. Even though there's multiple layers, you want sturdy stability to it. I wouldn't recommend Recollections 110-pound cardstock because that cardstock just doesn't crease very well when it comes to 3D dimensional projects, but you're more than welcome to use it if you want to. Again, I used 100-pound cardstock from Poptone. So let me move that to the corner, and we have the second one that created. I created it the exact same size, but I created it, of course, in my dark colors. So I used 100-pound cardstock for my base, and the gold cardstock is DCWV. I believe it's called the Black Craft stack, and this is from like 3 years ago, I think it is. I have so many stacks of it because I absolutely love it. So that's what I used to mat my purse. And then we have a 90-pound bright gold foil. I bought this from Paper and More. I don't remember the maker, So if you notice, there is one slight difference with the purse, and that is going to be this circle here. The file is intended for it to go in the background here, but while this is cute, I don't particularly see myself using it with a tassel. I prefer this option over here, so majority of my bags will be created this way. All I did was take that same circle that you see going back here, and I made it much smaller so it can fit on the actual flap. So it's like actual, like the ring that you would lift up to pull open your purse itself. And that's the option that I went with. So it is magnetized. I did go ahead and cover the magnet with black cardstock since the magnet is silver. I didn't want the silver clashing with the gold. So it is the exact same thing. I also covered the magnet on the top, but as you can see, same space. I cut this purse out in the exact same size that I did the original one at 120%. But as you can see, you go ahead and close it and it snaps shut. So here are the details and all of the matting for this particular purse. Again, super duper love this die. Well, I should say file. It is my absolute favorite and I see myself creating tons more. You can definitely, the benefits and the perks of an SVG file is you can resize them. You can create them as small or as large as you're capable of with your matting and cardstock. This is a perfect gift-giving purse. You can use it to give larger gifts or you can downsize it and do favors for birthday parties or weddings or bachelorette parties and stuff it with all kinds of different treats. So possibilities are endless with these style purses. Again, I hope you enjoy this project, and if you're interested, I will link the file in the description box below. And that is essentially it for my first project for the Stuff It collab. Again, please be sure to visit all of the participants in the collab. All of their channels will be linked in the description box below. I hope you enjoy, so please be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you think of this purse, and if you have it, if you've created it, or if you want to get it and you plan on creating it. Just let me know. Alrighty, again, play along with this, do a video or Instagram response, and be sure to tag it with the hashtag StuffItBoxBagCollab. Alrighty, I'm out of here. I hope to see you in the following months for all of the future collab videos, and thank you so much for stopping by. I appreciate it. Thanks so much for watching. Bye!